Hello, today I'm going to show you how to draw circular sound waves. Let's open a new document, change the fill to black and the stroke to none. Next, select the rectangle tool and draw a small square. With the rectangle selected, go to Object, Repeat and choose Grid. Let's extend the side and bottom handles to create more squares. Before we can edit the squares, first we need to expand them. Go to Object and choose Expand. Now click OK. Next, go to Layers and open the sublayers of Layer 1. Click on the circle next to the group layer and drag it to the top. Now select the clip group layer and press the delete key on your keyboard. Next, right-click on this group and select ungroup. And repeat this a couple times. Now we can switch to the selection tool and select each square individually. Next, we are going to create two variations of a sound wave segment. Let's duplicate this group. For the first variation, we are going to use the bottom as our reference row and randomly remove squares from the top of each column. We don't want to remove any squares from the reference row. For the second variation, we are going to use a central reference row. Let's say the third from the bottom and remove squares from the top and bottom of each column. Next, open the brushes window, select the top group and drag it here. Select the pattern brush and click OK. And OK again. Let's repeat the same steps with the other group. Now move everything outside the artboard. Let's swap the fill and the stroke, select the ellipse tool and draw a small circle. With the circle still selected, click on the first brush we've created. Let's scale it up. When we zoom in, you will notice no space between these two rectangles. To correct this, double-click on the brush that we used and change the Fit option to Add Space to Fit. Now highlight the number in the scale window and using the up or down arrow keys on your keyboard, adjust the space. We can also change the colorization method to tints. This will allow us to change the color of the waves later on. To scale our design without distorting its appearance, first we need to expand it. Go to Object and choose Expand Appearance. Let's resize it and change the fill to a different color. Next, draw another circle, make sure it has no fill, but this time apply the second brush. And repeat the same steps like we did before. Change the fit option to add space to fit. Go to Object, Expand Appearance, and scale it down. If you wish, apply a different color. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.